screw you, Ninja, and the turd you came in on. I tried to set up so I have a secondary machine to run the stream. That was a fail, and you suck. All right, that's fine. Lessons learned. Never try. So, let's get back into it. Hopefully, I sound a lot better. Back to the old setup quickly. You know, unplug the cables in and out. Wham, bam, thank you, man. Mr. Emerges here. Smiley's here. Doomsy's here as well. Hey, you joined me last week. Welcome. I'm glad you came back. So, all right. Let's go back into this. Welcome back. Way better. Yeah, there we go. All right, good. Good, good, good. Thank you. Lessons learned. All right. So, yes. That's like Marco. So, this is the plan for this landing gear. Is it's going to kind of like rotate down from here. So, it's actually going to sit directly up against the wing, if you want to call it that. And then it's just going to kind of like fold down and then it's going to extend. Welcome back. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you for returning, everyone. I'm sorry. Deja vu. Sorry about that, but it was bugging me. I only want to give you quality. I stepped on something. I stepped on a backpack. I only want to give you quality. Anyway, so here we are. We've got this, okay? So let's bring this in. And this is kind of like the idea that I want. Here, this is going to go control P, parent to object. So kind of like when this comes down, this will extend a little bit more flat. And so it's going to look something like that. And we can put our pistons from above, but why would we need that if it's coming down? That doesn't make any sense. That does not make any sense if I do it like that. I'm the best turkey mince. Absolutely. Time to go back. So, yeah, so that's irrelevant. So it's not really going to work. I thought it was a good idea, but it might not be. No, that's not going to work. It needs to be maybe some really big pylons. And then it's kind of maybe some small pistons based off that pylon. And then that's what kind of moves it down. So this is what I'm thinking next. Alt-R to reset that rotation. Shift-S cursor to selected. Some big get-stuffed pylons just like in Star Citizen. Okay. We will... I reckon that's a pretty good height. Yep. And we just have two of these. We're going to have two of these. New keyboard as well. So I don't know if you can tell, but you can't hear it. So it's a little bit different as well. It's a lot smaller. None of this RGB rubbish. Why not build a landing gear module just forward of the rear pods on the hull? Why don't you build it? Because it makes too much sense. Gosh dang it. Fine. Here? There? Or do we go in more? Because, I mean, yeah, we do have an empty space there. Okay, that might work. And we'll make the back open up, and then that's how they get in and out. For the front, because this is too flat underneath, I wouldn't mind building maybe a piece that goes directly under. Yeah, I've already done the sci-fi paneling, but that's, you know, small problem. So what I'm thinking there is if we go to World Origin and we go Cube, something along the lines of scale on the Z. Oh, maybe we could just put in some pipage or something just to break it up. Let's go on that top face, scale on the X. Something like that. And then, you know, we do my thing. Control B to do a bevel. And then something along the lines of that. And then it's kind of like gives that structure thing. Open up the back like a Hercules. Yeah. See, that's what I'm semi-thinking. And then that could work, because then that could work with Spooky's piece on the back here. We can have that attachment directly in there, and then it just comes down just a smidgen. All right, I reckon that might be the way to go. How are we feeling about that? It is a communal ship. That ship. Let's grab that. Let's go G to the Z, and we'll bring it to about there. Do we like this bottom bit? You know what? I reckon maybe. Hear me out. I reckon the bottom maybe can be just pipage. So for now, I'm just going to use the asset library just as a bit of a template. Let's go into models. Nope. Kitbash. This one, not console. Kitbashing 1. I know the pipes that I'm after. It is my favorite pipes, which are these ones. And so what I'm thinking is if we dump that one in there, let's now go into face project. Lovely. It's already enabled. And then we just kind of, the idea is throw some pipes in there. We can put that one in there as well. And then that one there I've already put on. Then we can even go like this one here, these two sets as well. So we've got this one, control, and that'll snap about there, right? About here-ish. About there, and then we've got one more, which is the big one here. I like this one. My favorite. They said it was $1 million shot, but I never seen the dumb that million. Probably about, nope, here. I'm just trying to find a nice spot, good enough. I think some nice pipes, maybe. Just in that way, we didn't have to pull the whole thing. Try pulling the center of the scale and bottom thing, create a huge bulge of some sort. Yeah. I don't know, I'm feeling the pipes. This is what I was thinking. And then we just like greeble the heck out of the bottom. I know I've got some really good parts in Kitbashing 3, but once again, we're gonna rebuild all this. Okay? We're gonna rebuild all this. I'm pretty sure I made some cool, there it is. My favorite. So I'm just putting in all my like favorite pieces in. Something like that. And then yeah, it's just kind of like hiding exposed pipes. Re-entry will be costly. Shut up, Emerger. Jerk. It's so right. Fine. Let's leave it as is. Dang it. You suck, Emerger. You suck. But it makes perfect sense. It's more annoying. Okay. Yeah, no. All right, fine. We will go with the bulk underneath. I'm sorry, Emerger. Okay, that was just cable. All right, let's go. Scale on the Y. Something like that. And then this is where we'll go back into what we did here. Initially, scale on the X. Let's scale on the Z, make it a little bit wider. And it's fine. We'll just redo all the like this heat stuff. Shouldn't be, it's not that big of, not too big of a problem. I know how to speak. The other thing as well, oh, by the way. So we, Blender Bob and I did a really big session on the Tiki movie this morning. So we did half the script. It's in the NASA space shuttle. Yeah, but yeah. Look, I'm gonna have to go with Merger. He, yeah. I'm gonna. Shut up, Smiley. I don't know. I do like the bottom though. You didn't. That's a joke. Oh. Shut up. Shut up, the both of you. Screw you guys. Where's my admin? I don't have an admin. to go with a bottom thing. Oh my goodness, hang on. I gotta engage with the audience. Start a poll. What are we calling this? Bulge thing on the bottom? Do we? Do I put a bulge on the bottom or do we just have it as flat plates? What do we reckon? Tell me now. What shall I do? Yes, 100% on the bulge at the moment. All right. I don't know how many votes. 6 votes. All right, bulge it is. Let us bulge away. Cool. All right, let's kind of put some more effort into this now. What do we got here? To the cockpit. I think you can do both. Yeah. Yeah, I think, you know what? I reckon that's probably a good idea to extend it all the way to there. Because at the end of the day, I actually need to extend. Oh, no. Because let's go back then. I'm going to build on this bulge first onto the bottom of the cockpit faces, and we'll bring that in like so. Oh, geez. We'll bring that in like so. E to extrude. I am going to scale it in because I got to give extra floor space. Once upon a time, I did create many, many moons ago when I was first learning Blender, is kind of like this spider landing gear where everything was under that center console and all four of the legs kind of like extended out and landed like that. I did do that. But I actually, you know what? Have I ever partnered with a real space architect? No, I have not. I'm actually spooky. You know what? Because what I can do. Hate you, spooky. Love you, spooky. Screw you, spooky. Okay, this is the idea. This is the idea. Is the landing gears themselves are going to be the bulge. So for instance, it's going to be like a landing gear like that. And then let's throw in a mirror modifier. I think this is maybe what you were referring to. We have like a bulge like that. And all it's going to do is going to push out on an angle. Think unfolding from upside down to the right side up. Think of folding upside down the right way up. What the heck are you trying to say? Because what I'm thinking, now if I go mirror off the cockpit, what I'm thinking is that it sits like so, and then it'll extend like that. That's the extension. Or even, I mean, we could even go like that way. But then where is the piston? The piston's on that angle. The near thing like a speaker. Yeah. I reckon, yeah, maybe we just do that. That's it. How is the landing gear going to look? There's a landing gear sit on an angle. Because then all the pressure comes out on the piston. Let's go delete vertices. We'll make that smaller. My I want to make a game and I have a good idea. Need support. Yeah, no, mate. Not here. Don't use Unity. There you go. There's my best advice. Don't use Unity. All right. But it needs to be beefy. Yeah, I completely agree. If you have a leverage system, it doesn't matter. Unity's dead. It always has been. It sucks. That's what it is. Maybe what it needs, hear me out. Maybe what it needs is when it's fully extended. Where's full extension? Like here-ish. Maybe when it's fully extended, we're going to do something like this. We're going to go C, delete those faces. And then I'm going to go ahead and have a stroke. Delete those faces. Let's go E to extrude. And so my idea is that maybe when this rotates, that's how it pulls it up. And then we'll just have another piston system that keeps it level. Maybe that'll be the case. My landing gear base faces up when stored, then unfolds, extends like an elbow, so the landing gear... What? What are you talking about? Let me jump on Discord. Spooky, get into chat if you can. I am super intrigued. What are you on about? If you can, jump into voice chat. I don't know if you can. And then I'll pull you down. There we go. All right, I think I can move you. All right, what the heck are you talking about? By the way, everyone can hear you. If you talk. Nope. All right. Oh, let's try again. Or do I have to give you special access to be able to talk? Hey, all right. Talk to me. Okay. Yep. Shut up! Oh, we can't. Oh, hang on, they can't hear you. Hang on. Hang on. Let me go back into the editor and turn up desktop audio, which is mute. Oh, get stuffed. I know why. Because I got to go like this and go into here. Real tech, go here. All right. Can you speak for me now?
Can you still hear me?
There we go. All right. Now I can hear you. I mean, now everyone can hear you. All right. No, okay. So, palm down.
No, palm up.
When you palm. Yeah. And then it kind of just goes, yeah, all right. I understand what you're saying now. But anyway, hey, welcome to the stream. Is there anything you want to, promote while you're here, buddy? Just put you on the spot.
Just my blender store, I guess.
What are you? I got you somewhere. Hang on. I will post that in chat somewhere. Give me a sec. I know where you are. Hang on, let me find the link. There it is. Copy. There we go. Go check out Mr. Spooky's Blender Store stuff. Anyway. Cool. All right. Well, yeah, there you go. Thanks. I will play with that. And yeah, cool. All right. I'll talk to you later.
Have a good one, Marcus.
See ya.
Bye.
Bye. All right. There we go. Now we're cooking with gas. Lost the plot. Anyway, all right. So I do like the idea. We're going to add in, yeah, probably just some extension pistons or something. So let's go into a cylinder. Oh, what am I doing? You dumb donkey. Let me quickly open up a file that has all my pistons in it. 3D stuff, 3D assets. Oh, gosh, I didn't put it in yet, have I? Blender, Marco's assets. No, where's my library? 3D assets. Oh, Marco, you suck. Marco's 3D assets? Where are my pistons? Library. Okay. Blender library. There we go. Pistons. Where are my pistons? Marco, you did it. You created something and then now you don't know where you put it, you dumb idiot. All right, let me just quickly jump on Patreon and download it. Bear with me for a sec. Let me just quickly jump on. Here it is. Pistons. Derry. Pistons. There we go. Let's just quickly download that. And then save it to a spot where I know. I will dump it there. Just give me one moment. Go back into the live stream. That's the cool thing about Patreon is I get to save where my stuff is. All right, paste. Here we go. Cool. There we go. Let's grab that. Yeah, there are some nice landing gears. Actually, I've downloaded that somewhere as well. Should you? Yeah. All right. So we're just going to grab you. Actually, no, you. And let's grab the big beefy one. U. Control C. Let's go back into our other blend file. Go away for now, please. Control V. Nice. Scale them down. Now I got to remember what was my process and how to do all this. Shift S, cursor to selected. Shift S, selection to cursor. And then we're going to do Shift S, selection to cursor. Oh, no. Other way. Shift S, selection to cursor. Make sure we select the armature. There we go. Let's go rotate 180. No. All right, now I got to remember how to do this. Because there's a special way of parenting everything. Let's go GX1. That one there links to that one. Control J, everything should go crazy, which is fine. Oh, that's because it's on the origin point. That's right. So, apply. Now when we go ahead and select these two, we go Control J to join. Then I select this one and that one, Control J to join. And now technically when we go into pose mode, I hate you. Oh, that's right, yeah. Select that, then that. Control P, parent objects with empty groups. Control P, keep transformation. Now if we go into pose mode, please work. Why? Why are you not working, you fat mole? Okay, solid. Let's select, that's fine. Let's select, that's fine. Let's make sure that this has the modifier on it. It doesn't. Fine. Armature. This one. Done. You happy? Now when you select on this, pose mode, G.
Thank you. Thank you.
Okay. Now we can go into edit mode, rotate, shift S, selection to cursor. Rotate 180, GZ. What the heck? What the heck? Hang on, which one's top? Let me just check, who's the parent? Nobody's the parent, which is fine. You're my parent, so that means you need to be the parent of bottom. Cool, because then when that moves, oh yeah, it's that whole far at that thing. All right, you know what? Sorry, I gotta remember my tutorial. I can't remember right now. Let's just make it all from scratch because I'm getting frustrated. Okay, so Shift S, Curse World Origin. Let's go ahead and gonna create, let's go a cylinder, scale, rotate. And we're just gonna extend that. Maybe what we will do is G to the Y, and we'll bring it all the way back so it's like that. Let's throw in a mirror modifier on the Y axis, not the X. The rotation point will actually probably be about here, and then that way when this rotates down, that'll just all come down, and then, oh, far out, dude. And goodbye. Mind you, he's technically the chat there is good for the stream, but no, let's not. So when this rotates down, that'll push it down, and then we can have another set of little pistons that kind of straightens it out. Yeah, I think that's the way to go. So G to the Z, that's where we're going to have it. Let's kind of build that structure that's going to be holding the landing gear. We're going to be out over here a little bit more. From here, let's go into clipping. I'm going to grab this face here, shift right click, and we're going to put in a spin tool. E to extrude. There we go. Delete faces. What about Godot? Oh, gosh. Oh, gosh. Godot's actually pretty good. The fact that Godot has a visual scripting thing, That is absolutely awesome. The visual scripting is something that I learnt to use very quickly. I do have a few tutorials on how to use it. So if you want to go down the Godot route, hey, I've used it before, and I can say it's not bad. It is not bad. All right, so if I'm going to, let's go Shift S, and let's go Alt G to reset the rotation and all that. So now we go G to the Y. Yeah, some giant get stuffed landing gear like so. There we go. And then that's what that base is going to look like. I reckon I've got this too far here. So I'm going to bring it back a little bit. And then that'll go, yeah, look, plenty. Nice. Let's go with that. Who tested Fab from? I don't know what that is. Nah, screw Unity. I said it before and I'll say it again. I've actually always said screw Unity. I've never liked that as a game engine. But that was because probably I'm too stupid to be a game developer. Even though I've developed several games. For those of you who have been around on my channel for quite some time, we did a VR squat game. And that's where you do squats. I know that sounds kind of stupid, but trust me. It was actually pretty good. Okay, from here, I am going to Shift D to duplicate that. And I'm just going to delete this edge here. And then we're going to extend everything. So from here, make sure we got that clipping enabled, mirror object, lovely. I'm going to select the edge, to edge, E to extrude along the X axis. Nice. Why does that look a little bit off? That's fine, whatever. And then from here, we're going to go E to extrude along the Y axis. Marco, select everything. E to extrude along the Y axis. And then this is kind of like the basis of that bottom bit. And then we can come in and add in, you know, the greebly bits that you know I love. Control B. And then we can grab this face in here. G to the X. Face, please. Face. Face. There we go. G to the X. Nice. And then we can kind of just layer that up. Should rotate the opposite way so the landing gear sits away from the center. Yes, you are correct once again. All right, let's flip that around. Beautiful. And now let me just kind of close this section off. E to extrude along the Y axis. Nice. Shift N, make sure that all the normals are correct. And then we'll go back and fill in all those gaps a little bit later. So the plan is, let's rig this quickly. Is that where it's going to sit? That is where it's going to sit. So, let's find the center of that circle. So here, Shift S, cursor to selected. From here, our armature is going to be like so, Shift A, single bone. Okay, cool beans. G. Probably about here-ish. I think that's, nope. This is the line here. And then that'll be connected to another bone, which would be this one. Let's go like this. So we know that this one here, we know that first. Where's my armature? There you go. All right, let's select the armature. We're gonna call this one landing gear underscore front right. And oh, landing gear FR, the bone, top rotate. This one here is going to be bottom plate. Sorry, I'm late. Sorry. So this will probably end up being for a scene eventually. I'm hoping tomorrow, if I've got the kahunas to do a full 24-hour live stream, I'm hoping to get all the mocap, do animation, character creation, hopefully make the first episode. Also, oh my goodness! Ow! 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 Hang on. So, now, I, Mr. Price, Andrew Price, the Blender Donut Guru, he is in to do a voiceover. He is in to do a voiceover, okay? The Blender Guru man, Pricey boy from Queensland, is in. I'm trying to find an email. I don't know. Hang on, where is he? I'm trying to find it now. Where is he? There he is. Mr. Price. Snip that puppy. Let me show you. No. Hey, sorry. Where is it? Let me know. Oh, that's kind of boring. Anyway, I got an email from him. And he's in. I do have him say donut. He is the guy that's selling me a donut. So a couple of weeks ago on one of the live streams, we made a donut shop, a sci-fi donut shop. Let me bring it up. F-Drive, Mark and 3D Studios, Medium Frigate. No, let's go. Donut Takeaway is the blend file. What we called it, V2. This is the donut shop that we created on live, where Pricey Boy is going to do the voiceover. I hope. Hopefully, unless he kind of like goes, man, you sound like a little bit of a tool bag. Maybe not. But no, hopefully. So this here, this is me doing the crowd creation add-on. But for those of you who remember, we built this a while ago. This is the donut shop that we developed. And so this is kind of like where the main character's going to come in and go, well, I'm hungry. Well, what do you got? Donuts. Ow! Come on, load up. Is it loading? I think it's loading textures. I think it's loading everything. This is probably a bad file to open up. But yeah, this is the donut shop. I want donuts. Ben Fox is here! That was loud. I'm sorry. But anyway, so, yes. So this is the donut shop that we'll be making. Oh, sorry, using as he's, yeah, selling it. So I'm pretty chuffed. Do not sound like a tool bag. We got voices. Whoop. So I'm pretty chuffed about that. I am so chuffed when he said it. All right, let's go back to being a bit normal. All right. Far out. All right, so let's grab that and that, and then we're going to select our armature. There we go. Control P, parent with empty groups. So now that we've... thanks for the shout out. Now that we've parented it all, so from here we can go in, select our mesh. So if we go into object, we can see both. We know we need top rotate for this one. And this one here is going to be our bottom plate. La-di-da. And then when we come and select this, let's go pose mode. And we're going to make sure this is going to be selected. Visibility. Nope. Viewport display. In front. So now when, I think this is what Spooky's saying, this will rotate down, but then we'll keep that like so. And then we've kind of got that. That's what it's roughly going to look like. Obviously, the landing gear, we're going to need separate armatures. We're going to need separate armatures for the landing gears. But yeah, I'm not going to have it fold away anywhere. It's literally just going to sit down. That's where it goes. So I think that's probably the best plan. I think, Mr. Spooky, you've told me where to go. Yeah. And if I can just, line it up like that. Yeah, are we happy with that? I think it'll be wider as well. Because you have to remember this is moved over, so this one would be over here. But is that enough? I reckon it is enough. Yeah? Why not session? What? Let's unleash my families away. Yeah. See? My people know me. I can be loud. I mean, technically we can overextend it. But I think then it's not much benefit. I reckon, yeah. Yeah, I think maybe we just go straight down. And then that way all the pressure is all the way down. Yeah, I think that's probably just the way to go. All right, let's kind of, we'll take that, we'll run with it. And let's kind of go ahead and continue building this. We will come back and do all the panels. Let's maybe just work on the interior. So how this system's actually going to work. So from here, let's select this piece. Let's grab that, G to the X, like so. I'm gonna shift a D on that, rotate 90 degrees. I'm gonna get it roughly in the middle because that's gonna be the rotation point of our pin. Let's go something like that. From here, we can go GY, E to extrude, all right. And then from there, let's select that interior face there. I to do an inset. E to extrude, scale on the y-axis 0. Delete faces. Select all, merge by distance. There we go. So now we've got our kind of like coupling. Okay, let's just get rid of that for now. Now we've got that coupling. I think it's a little bit, it's not enough. Let's go scale. Scale, shift X, shift Y, bring it in. There we go. And so that's going to be kind of like that. Yes. Spooky is always right. You should do a mark. I get some interesting comments. The best ones are on my best performing videos, on the most liked videos, people are like, doesn't work. This is a stupid tutorial. I'm like, what? Get stuffed. Go suck a lemon. God, Jesus, spat everywhere. Oh, those are the ones that get me. I'm like, oh, yeah. What? Do you suck the drugs? All right, let's go like so. There we go. From here, let's grab this. We'll grab this, shift D, scale X minus 1, scale Y minus 1, there we go, G, Y, E to extrude, scale Y minus 1, lovely. And then from here, we're going to do the same. Now, this is the part that's going to be connecting to the actual pin. The reason I'm agreeing with Spookies now is because I had... Did not talk about it. Scorn cells. Gosh. Let's go like so. Oh, come on, Marco. Bring that into the middle. Scale Y. GY. Let's just line that up as much as possible. Lovely. Go away. Oh, gosh. All this going in and out. Ah, new keyboard, who this? face, control L, scale on the Y, select these two faces, E to extrude, scale on the X, Y, gosh dang it. Marco, come on, man. This isn't your first rodeo. E to extrude, scale, shift Y. Yeah, that's fine. All right, awesome. So that's kind of like our pin. Fat fingers. There we go. So we've got our bottom bit like that. From here, I'm going to select all this, control L, shift A, let's add in a cubey McCube cube. What? L. Delete vertices. Control L, shift S, cursor to selected, shift A, add in a cube. There we go. There we go. Now we're cooking with gas-ish, kinda. Oh my goodness. And to think I'm gonna be trying to do a 24-hour live stream. I don't think I can pull it off in the slightest. Alt-H. Where's the bottom? There it is. All right. So let's grab that piece there. And we're gonna go GZ. GZ and push that all the way up. Let's flange this out. So I'm going to try and do as much work as possible. Something like that. Scale along the X. And then we'll go from there. Like that. Scale along the X. And then we're going to grab just the bottom face, scale along the X. All right. So we kind of have that support piece in there. Where are you? Hide, 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 hide. Yep, that's not too bad. Nice chunky piece in there. Let's go ahead. I'm going to select probably an edge loop through here, edge loop through there. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. Let's do an eye to do an inset. Delete face from here to here. And then we just go all the way around. I could probably come over to help keep you motivated for a few. Oh, actually, yeah. Yeah, 24 hours seems pretty ambitious. But you know what? It's like worth a shot. It's probably the only time that I'm ever going to be able to do it. So that's why I'm just... Yeah. But Smiley, it's... I reckon it might be an option. It might be an option. So now I've also got a female voice artist. She be hydrated, absolutely. Modest Pelican. He taught us well. If you don't know who Modest Pelican is, go check out his channel. A little bit of crude humor. So I'm warning. I actually haven't watched him for a while. But yeah, it's pretty crude. So just a heads up. Mirror that. I'm going to mirror on the y-axis. Nice. So yeah, this is kind of like that point where it's going to be connecting here. And then here, this is where I'm going to put the piston to be, to keep it balanced. I think that's probably the more important thing. Hoo-ah! And then we can now do a mirror. So I've got two mirrors on this. There we go. Excellent. So that means now what we'll do is we'll do a test animation. So if I come into pose mode, let's go like this. I rotation. And then at 100, it's going to be rotating like so. We're going to do something like that and something like that. Now, I'll probably try and rig this up later with IK and FK. So I only have to put the bone in the one spot. All right, cool beans. From here, let's go I rotation. Oh, yeah, boy. Okay, so you can see how this is moving first, but we kind of want to move it in the opposite direction. Now, the simple way to change that is move the mirror modifier, because at the moment, it goes mirror modifier, solidifier, armature. But if I move the mirror modifier underneath the armature, now they go outwards. Oh, so I don't have to do that. Oh, sweet. I don't have to rig the other side. Do I? This is the problem. If I go to Omniverse, I do. Crap. That's all right. Future market problem. Alt H. Whoa. Alt H. There we go. Yeah, there we go. So that's what it looks like. Settle down, mate. Let's come there. Scale 2. Do we feel that? You feel me, boy? Hang on, what the? Oh. that? You, sir, need to be to that. Control P, parent arms and empty groups. You select all that. You become bottom plate assign. Nice, there we go. Now that I look at that, that is stupid thin. That is not gonna work. All right, let's bring that back up. Let's extend this out now. We're gonna grab these two pieces and thus scale on the X. Give it some chunky love. Really bad design. No triangles whatsoever. That's actually not too bad. No, you don't need to rig the other side. You just need a mirror. Yeah. And blender mirror armature. No, so the reason why I need to rig the other side is because when I go into NVIDIA Omniverse, Omniverse doesn't have a mirror modifier. And don't need a piston for moving the bottom bit. Yeah, I will. Yeah. That piston's coming in. The piston is coming in. It's hot. Okay. So, from Nyar. What's the best way? Where do we put it? Because, I mean, technically we can put the piston kind of like on here. It's got to be on there, doesn't it? I mean, technically, we could almost have a piston here. Yeah, so, all right. So, Doomsy, if I apply the mirror modifier, then when that bone moves, it's just going to move everything, even on the right-hand side. But yeah, spooky, it can extend really far. Hang on, where? You reckon go all the way around? What I might do, I might just Shift D. I'm just going to copy that. Shift D, duplicate that. Just put it over to the side. You reckon we should go out further, all the way around? To be something like that. Okay. I rotate. Let's just go Shift D. Let's go from here. Let's bring our main ship back. Yeah, so I'd have to make it super bulkier. And that means, yeah, that these pieces here would have to be really big. Then translate the upper thing to the inside of the ship. Yep. You reckon like that, huh? Go out super wide. All right. I mean, it can be done. All right, ship, go away. We're going to have to bulk the heck out of this thing. How does those landing gears rotate is the next question. Because technically, you would need two... MV, welcome. Technically, you would need another rotation pin. Because, yeah, this... Because, yeah, this one can rotate. But it needs to have a way to rotate that around. So it needs a second pin. Far out. All right, future market problem. Let's not worry about that. Let's kind of create some support pits now. We're going to go Shift D like so. Let's go GZ. Scale on the Y axis. Let's go GG. E to extrude along the X axis. And we're going to go rotate. Control L, GZ. And we're going to just grab that. Let's move it all the way in. And then that gives us kind of like that little bit of support in there. This bit here, I'm going to apply that solidify modifier now. And then from here, we could probably just go I to do an inset, I to do another inset. And then from here, face mode, Alt, E to extrude. Let's go scale on the x-axis, and then we've got something like that. But obviously now as well, we can probably build in some more, just kind of extra bracing, because obviously we're going to need brace. Nice, I like that. It's just ever so slight touch, sweet touch. You are more than I ever need. It's a space turtle. What? But yeah, so talking on the live stream with one of the developers from BMW, it was really interesting to see like the boxes they use. I know it sounds really stupid, but it's really good to see kind of like all the curves and how that's utilized for strength. So I reckon we might do something like that. And that was kind of like the first thing that I really noticed. Because obviously like in a submarine, we expect. That's off kilter. Oh, dang it. In a submarine, they've obviously got like a lot of these kind of like reinforcement points so that it doesn't buckle so well. Nub, nub, welcome. I have no idea where I was going with that. Let's drop, whatever. Just smile and wave, boys. Just smile and wave. Okay, there's our little bevel on there now. Let's grab that line. I'm going to go E to extrude along the Z axis and we'll bring it up. Cool. Ooh, that's not exactly what I wanted. That's fine. Buy that for a dollar. Let's grab this and we're just going to just extend that to the right a little bit. Nice. And we'll extend that edge, GX. Oop, we will extend Alt S. Shift Z. Get stuffed. Scale X 0. GX. GX. Just kind of get that in line. Lovely jubblies. Cool. And then let me just quickly just grab that. I'm going to go G to the Y. Push it out a bit. G to the X. Push it out a little bit. Scale X, scale Y, scale X. Come on, Marco, you can do this. G, Y. G, GY. Whatever, so we'll fix that up later. But yeah, all right, I'm fairly happy with that landing gear. Definitely there's gonna have to be more pistons in there. How to work that one out, I don't know. Exams, ew. Spaceships and submarines. Pretty much, I accept. All right. And so now that leaves that like so. All the way out. Lovely lejublies. And I mean, technically what we could do is I can just go for now, select all this, select this, G. Yep, sweet. Shift D, Y, G, Y, and we bring it back. G, Y. Cool. Let's just grab that edge. Shift S, cursor to selected. What number is that on the Y axis? Control C, Control C. Let's grab that. Control V. I hate you. Global. Control C on the global. And then that way when I do Control V, lovely. And then from there, E to extrude along the Y axis. And then we'll do it again. There, Control C, make sure we go back into local, and Control V, nice, E to extrude along the y-axis. Now all I have to do is just delete these two faces, and now that's opened up our landing gears. Definitely needs to be beefed up a bit more. I think, yeah, these are definitely too small. So maybe what we might do is I'm just gonna put an edge loop through here, edge loop through there. Let's go E to extrude, something like that. Big get stuff pistons. Oh, I've gotta redo it on that one. Sorry, we'll leave that for later. Is that clipping through there? It is not, so that's good. From here, let's throw on, oh, we've got a solidify modifier already on there. We might make it a bit thicker. Period key. Is it touching? Nope, excellent. Perfect. And then, yeah, we'll create some sort of device up there as well, so it's a little bit more hidden. At the end of the day, probably we'll never really see a shot of that opening up. Oh, actually, we might. I lie. Because obviously, if we're watching it come down land. The heck was that? So yeah, we might actually. Now that I come to think about it. Cool. Bananas. So for those of you who have just joined, welcome. 22 people. Barely anyone. Lovely. I know that the time zones now have stuffed up because I'm now in daylight savings. So I've gone back an hour? I've gone forward an hour. So maybe that's a good thing. If it was 8 o'clock when I, if it's 10 o'clock when I started. Yeah, no, then I, and that means 9 o'clock for me. Yeah. So anyway, that kind of, it is better. All right. Thrusters for landing. Oh gosh, not that again. Yeah, maybe. I think you might be right for a landing gear. I think you are right. I'll tell you what, while we're here, let's just quickly smash out some paneling. All right, let's go. Let's apply that solidify modifier. I'm gonna go ahead and grab, ooh. Hang on. Uh-oh. Undo. Select all, Shift N, make sure the normal's the right way, then go Control A. Excellent, that's much better. Uh-oh. Did I grab it all? Yep. We're going to just grab all this stuff. Quickly make some panels from it. Actually, whoa, no, Marco, the final shape's not ready yet. So let's go E to extrude one more time. Undo. Oh, undo. There we go. All right, let's go E to extrude along the Y axis. Let's go like so, E to extrude, oops, sorry, GY. Like so, E to extrude along the X, like so. I'm gonna put an edge loop through there, because then that becomes there, and then that becomes that. Oh yeah, good enough. And then that is gonna be hidden by the front. All right, perfect, lovely, love it. Let's make sure we make let's make sure that all the normals are the right way. Solidify, modify, turn that on. Thank you. And now we can grab everything on the outside. Beautiful. In here. Yar, 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 yar. Whoops, nothing in there. Did I grab? I did. You fat mole. Oh, no. Okay, cool. I think now we're fine. Anyone from Australia? Who's going to SIGGRAPH? Anyone? Anyone going to SIGGRAPH in Sydney? Let's do a shift DP separate by selection. And then from there. Nope. Hang on, which one? Oh gosh, I don't even know which one I've got now. Okay, hide. There we go. From here, let's go into Solidify Modifier on the zero. It's gonna be a little bit thicker, lovely. All right, let's just quickly make some panels. Here, there, Control B to that, delete faces, do another one through there, delete faces. Just bear with me while we just quickly smash all this out. There we go, Control B. I'm from a reverse Australia. UK? I don't know. What's that? What's the reverse of Australia? I'm going to be British. British? You know what I mean? Yeah, nah. I mean, technically, Britain? You know what I mean? Britain? Is semi-Australia? Primarily, I mean, most of us are.
Most of the convicts, eh?
The US and Australia have inverted and upside down shapes in comparison. We're about the same size. But I wouldn't exactly say that we're inverted. Oh, I see what you're saying. I understand what you're saying. I understand. I just disagree. All right, we're getting there. Slowly but surely.
I told you, don't call me Shirley. All
right, let's go like so. G, Y. And then here as well. G, Y. Just kind of make that. All right, there's our panels. All right, probably here. Oh, no, we won't put one there. Let's go here. Nope, let's go here. Delete faces. We need one here. Delete faces. Nice, 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 nice. That's looking good. We need this to be, have a bit of a cut. Oops. Scale X zero, Control B. And so as you can see, this is kind of like just how I make my panels. My brain's going nuclear. It's pronounced nuclear. Talking about Jill. Sadly. You don't understand what kangaroos are. They are the jerks of the forest or the outback. They are stinking numpties. They are la-dangerous, is what I gotta say. There's been a few times riding the mountain bike. Oh, where's my drone? Do I have drone footage? I might have drone footage. Get that. Where is that piece? There. There. I would have put it here, but I didn't put it there. It should be there, but it's not there. Why isn't it there? I have drone footage of kangaroos. Let me find that stupid little SD card. It's a little connection. I did some 3D printing the other day. It would have been here. There's some documents and paperwork. Where are you? Why are you not here? We are sinking. What are you thinking about? We are sinking.
I'm getting old. My legs.
All right. I don't know where that dongle is. I've got a dongle. That's for cards and such. Oh, by the way, in the link, is linked down somewhere. I've got a whole bunch of free stuff you can download. You just got to find it. Okay. Where is it? Now this is frustrating. Hang on. Are you going to find it? I am going to show you kangaroos. Slightly frustrating. Because I actually kind of need it. Oops, don't turn the drone on, Marco. Getting the SD cards a pain in the bum.
Pain in the butt talks.
Oop, is it there? Oh, there it is.
Yes. Aha! Oh, jeez. Okay, put that in there.
Let me just get the drone out. Yeah, there we go. I saw someone just downloaded something. Come on. Come on, Mr. SD. There we go. All right, let's
bring up some drone footage.
There we go. Plug that in. And, where are you, Mr. Drone? DCM Media. 11th of the 7th. What's 11th of the 7th? Oh, yeah, okay. This is me chasing. Yeah, there we go. Kangaroos. See? Just around the back of my house. That's what kangaroos look like from the sky. Bunch of jerks. And, Oh, that's a garbage truck. Woo! All right, not that one. There we go. Some more kangaroos. Getting down low. This one's giving himself a bit of a scratch. Rats. They are. They're giant rats. Look at them. Look at the punks. Anyway, there we go. That's all I wanted to show you. That's kangaroos for you. I went to Australia and they asked me for right of entry. I ask if felony is still accepted. I mean, you're not wrong. All right, we're almost there. Then once we've created all this, then we're going to make some indents. And those indents is what I feel pull it off even more. So if we do a control B and then we do a control B, then we select this and we go GG. All right. Now, if I'm just going to do an Alt H, unhide that. I'll probably go do all that on Discord a little bit later. So that's what we got. Shift S. Let's go down into DreamUV and we'll quickly texture everything. So hotspot that puppy, please. And let's go into material mode. How the hell do you take care of a kangaroo? Koala 99. Koalas are stupid. It's funny because it's true. All right, let's go like that. Nope. Let's click that and then like that. And then we go copy material to selected. Oakley doggly. And we'll do the same for that. So we go that to that. Copy material to selected. Make sure we hotspot on that as well. Lovely. And now we can see, whoops, down here as well, hotspot. Let's also select that bottom piece. Not you. Come on. Stop being a jerk. You. Perfect. Hotspot. Hotte spotte. Painted gray. Get staffed. You're meant to be painted. Oh, crud. Copy materials are selected. Yeah, perfect. Look at that. That's in that. I mean, it does look pretty cool. Let's have a look with the landing gear extended. Yeah. I think definitely that whole system needs to be quite big. Put a raven brain and a kangaroo new primary species on it. What? Look, kangaroos, oh my goodness, they are, especially where I am, they are stinking everywhere, and they're dangerous, because they're idiots, and they jump in front of cars. Huh? What's that? Bang. Luckily, thank goodness, I've never hit, have I? I've hit one once, but he was fine. The worst things to hit are a wombat, because a wombat is a walking tank. Sorry, a walking rock. Wombat. Yeah, look at these things. These things, right here. Look at the size of this thing. Image. Wombat. Small little wombat. These are probably... they could probably get to about the same size as 5 basketballs, like a big rubbish bag. It's, yeah, you hit a wombat, your car's in trouble. None of this, jump in a Cadillac. No. This will hurt the Cadillac. Well, look who it is, Bieber. I saw a wombat on the side of the road. Well done. It's like hitting a bear. Hit a bear once. A moose. Oh, mooses are massive though. Like a proper moose. You're not, eh? And we're spooky, eh? Ah, it's a moose. come on. Moose. Yeah, look at the size of these things. Look at this gigantor. Far out. Like, give that a slide tackle. That's freaky. Better hope he isn't waiting for you in the afterlife. Ah. Oh. Look at this. Look at the size of that. That's massive. Anyway. Put loose, welcome. Guys, is 24/7 divisible. Why is 27? What? It's me. You know me, I am me, yes. All right, so back to this. Let's kind of go, what are we gonna do? Let's separate our glass pieces. Actually, you know what would have been easier? Select, P, separate by selection. There we go. And now I'm just gonna press hide. And so this is gonna be kind of like our central piece for the cockpit. Yes, it is divisible. I don't know. Moose will kill you if you hit it with your car because... yeah, and that's kind of what I think, Spooky. That's the way I picture a moose. You take out its legs and it's going to fall on you. And that's when the problem happens, eh? Okay, so, yeah, last stream we were kind of like working on this. Let's kind of now carry on with this whole section. Shift-S cursor, whatever. Let's go into a cube. We're going to do edge loop through there, V to rip, Control-L delete vertices. Ho-ho. All right. I do think we'll probably go for another, I don't know how long. I probably should rest my voice. Or Blender Bob's gonna kill me. He sure will. From here, let's go on the y-axis. We're gonna throw on that mirror modifier. Make sure clipping is enabled. Let's go ahead, grab that, grab that face there, GZ. Move it up, nice. Let's grab that there. I'm just gonna move it back. Whoops, GX to a point. There we go. What we might do is actually step it down. Well, actually, no, we gotta make a floor, don't we? Ah, oh, that's right, that's what I was doing. Oh, that's right, that's what I was doing. Hang on. Delete. I now remember why I did these things. Select that, that, and that. Cool. Shift D, P, separate by selection, okay? I wanna select that bottom piece, scale Z, zero, GZ. No, let's not. Let's go scale Z, zero, GZ. And we do something like that because it's gonna give us more headroom. From here. Beautiful. E to extrude along the y-axis. Let's grab these here, scale X, zero. GX, about there. Okay, I do, unfortunately I can't move this out of the way just yet. Let's go E to extrude along the Z axis. That'll give us that. G, Y. And then that'll kind of give us a little step up. So that's kind of cool. When you walk out, you kind of step in and you're into that cockpit. Wasn't kind of, if you hit an animal, don't swerve except for a moose. Yeah, I think that's the rule here as well. Like technically, you're not meant to be swerving for animals. If you're gonna hit them, hit them. Just this kind of like a safety thing. It's not that we're like against animals. It's more just a safety to be part of that kind of like predictableness. If that's a word. Okay, let's grab that, that, that. Whoops. E to extrude. I'm gonna go Z. Like that. Did I miss something? No. Hide. Delete faces. Delete edge. Delete edge. Delete edge. All right. So what I do need to do is curve that in. So we go Alt H, I'm gonna go hide and hide. This bit here just needs to move over a smidgen. GX, so it hits with the wall. Mind you, this base bit doesn't have a modifier on it yet, is in solidify modifier. So let's go ahead, probably turn that on. Like so. Give it a bit of thickness, nice. And then this is where we could probably grab all the floor planes. GZ. Not you then, GZ. Perfect, that's looking pretty good. That's now clipped into there quite nicely. Something like that. Beautiful. And that covers that bit. Now we're working on the kind of like transition between all this. Let's go merge by distance. Nice. This worries me a little bit. I feel like this is wrong. Technically, there should be like an edge loop through here. Merge at center. And then when I click that, beautiful. When I click that, awesome. All right. Woof. What's the time? 8:40. Beautiful. 9:40. 10:40. 11 o'clock. 10. Anyway. Okay. So from here, we're going to extend this up to the point. Let's go Alt-H now. Oops. Let's go Alt-H now to unhide. Hide the glass. And we go GZ. Probably to the top. Actually, we don't really have to go to the top. Let's kind of cover it like so. Clipping is turned on. Awesome. E to extrude along the x-axis. Delete. Whoops. Delete. Delete faces. All right. And then we can just kind of start adding in some extra edges through here. And we can just kind of like fan that out. Oops. Like so. Oh my goodness. Yeah, it's going to be a bit of work to get that cleaned up. Yeah, right. Oh, jeez. So technically, we could probably maybe select this and that. Control I, invert the selection and hide. Nope. Yep. Hide. Nope. That and that. Control I, hide. Excellent. And then we can kind of just build it around this because we know that this here is the biggest problem. G. Something like that. Does this have a solidify modifier? It doesn't. Ah! Wait a minute. I didn't realize that. All right, let's do quickly fix that up. Get rid of that, 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 and I think that's it. Delete vertices. Did we get rid of it all? We did not. Delete vertices. Now we can come in, add that solidify modifier. Give it a bit of thickness, maybe a little bit more. Just to chunky that up, and now we can hide that transition a lot better. Oh my goodness. Scale Z0. There we go. Let's grab this now. New sub. Sick. Who subbed? Subtype. Welcome. Wow. You're my only sub for tonight. I appreciate that you've hit the subscriber button. Anyone else that is new? Welcome. Where's Terry? That's his job. I don't have headphones. That's why I can't hear them. I can't hear them coming in, as they say. Excellent. All right, so we've done that now. We've given that a little bit of extra lovey McLove love. Let's do an Alt-H. Get rid of that. There we go. So now we've kind of got a really good transition point. I mean, we could... Technically, I could go GG, GG, GG. Oops. Select all, merge by distance. There we go. And it kind of opens up the rest of the ship together. It comes, it opens up the entire ship. So this is where later on we can come in and just build all that back stuff. Obviously create all our panels and such all through here. I don't have anything really. I am thinking that this piece here should be separate. So I'm going to press V to rip, Control L, and just for now, we're going to deselect all this. GZ, which is fine. I am going to close this up, F. Close that up. And if I go GZ, will it move? Nope. G, GZ. Something like that. Lovely. So that now when I come in, actually, we can probably just put in a bevel and that will hopefully fix everything. It does not. Let's go merge by distance. I think I've got some. I think this is my problem up here. All these triangle bits. Dang it. Dang it, Bobby. Dang it, Bobby. No. Ah, you suck. Or maybe it's this bit here. It doesn't know how to do that. Yeah, I think that's the problem there. Darn it. Whew. All right. Lick bugs off the front of my car. That's far out. Yeah, that's not cool. That would be a very unpleasant... Oh, get stuffed. I get stuffed. Yeah, okay. Control B. I'm just going to do a bevel. GZ. And we'll just do it all manually. Cool. That and that. Oh, I see. Control B. Nice. And then, yeah, we can come in and create some floor playing and such. Whoa, Kanye. How's everyone going? Not a lot of people, but hey. Dying on the inside. What? I don't know. Alright. I've got serious doubts about doing a 24-hour live stream now. I don't have the energy or the mental capability. How many people have we had? 233 viewers. That's it. Far out. That sucks. That sucks. Anyway. Alright. Let's call it a night. I need an early night's sleep. I think I'll probably do a stream tomorrow night. And let's just go for as long as I can go. And we'll see what happens. So tomorrow night, I'm going to try and do mocap, facial animation, character animation. Let's try and make the first episode of the web series. Let's... I got to do that. Yeah, so there's a whole bunch of stuff. Let's worry about it tomorrow, and we'll go from there. Yeah, interesting. All right, let's call it a night. Thanks, guys.